You're the only one for me. You're the only thing I need. You're the only one they want for. You're the only one my heart adores. You're the only one I've lived for. You're the only one my heart adores. You're the only one I've lived for. You're the only one my heart adores. You're the only one for me. You're the only one I need. You're the only one for me. You're the only one for me.
So we're going to let Hannah tune real quick, and while we do that, we're going to make some declarations.
Amen.
So, how you guys been doing with your declarations?
Good.
Okay?
Yeah.
Are you getting 100?
Yeah.
No?
No, no. I need to get 100.
I've had a couple days where I've missed 100. I've done probably at least 50 to 60 there's been a couple days that I didn't get the full 100 in.
Right.
So.
Me too.
So.
Does it count if we did more than 100 on another day?
Even it out? Yeah.
So I want to, is there any theme that anybody is getting in their decorations that the Holy Spirit is giving them? Is there a theme?
Well, I know I've been getting one, and that's just the, like, because we're supposed to go, and I'm in this class, and we're going, and all about seeing God do his thing, and so it's pretty exciting.
Amen.
Signs and wonders, signs that make people wonder. Amen. God is real.
Amen.
God is real.
He is. Amen.
Awesome. I have something I want to read to you guys.
Get on the mic, sir.
What's that?
You have to get on the mic.
I'm trying to let her. I don't know. Yeah. Read it.
Oh, I see.
So, hello, atmosphere shifters.
Yeah.
Truth speakers.
That's us.
How was your first week of declaring truth? Did you find speaking at least 100 declarations a day challenging or easier than you expected? I thought it was going to take way more time.
And she can't do it.
She can't do it. Okay.
Okay. My bad.
I thought it was going to take way more time, and I actually found that the times that I've done 100, it felt like it didn't take the entire time. Did you hit any roadblocks? Anybody have any roadblocks?
Yes.
Okay.
Time,
that was mine too. Okay. Did the process teach you anything about beliefs you currently hold about yourself or God or circumstances in your life? So we declare Holy Spirit is encountering you today in this process of discovery. We're going to have fun the rest of the week. With life being given and joy being poured out. So, for the remainder of the week, we want to focus on raising our expectations for tomorrow. Okay? So, raising the expectations. There was a book that came out called The Epic by John Eldridge, and it was basically about the story that God is telling. And the premise towards the end is that we're now in the third chapter. And
I'm in the fourth now?
We're in the fourth chapter. And that you are a part of the story that God is telling, and there's a wild hope that begins to stir inside of you when you allow your imagination to dwell on the goodness of God. So knowing that God is good and allowing your imagination to think of, okay, so I was one of those people that heaven sounded okay, heaven sounded good, I like worshiping God, but I thought it was basically going to be an eternal church service in the sky. And there are other things that I like, there's other passions that I have, there's other things, and I know God gave them to me because they're good things. And I thought, so John Evans painted this picture of what wild hope looks like. And it's the anticipation of good. And so the greatest, the most beautiful thing you've ever seen on the earth is nothing compared to what eternity is going to be like. The greatest thing you've ever experienced is nothing compared to what you're going to get to experience in eternity.
The most fun thing you've ever done.
Right.
The most fun thing you can ever remember isn't as fun as heaven will be. I'm having to hang on to that.
Right. And so the passions that you have, so some of my passions are, I love to ski, I love to ride motorcycles, I love to go on hikes, I love to whitewater raft, I love to do things that, you know, exhilarate me, and I know that I'm alive when I'm doing them. And so I know that I'm going to get to taste something like that even greater in eternity. And so that you allow that wild hope. So John 10:10 says that in the second part, Jesus says that I've come to give life and that you have it more abundantly. And that life starts right now. Right now, our eternal life is not when we die. We actually start eternal life now.
Yeah,
so then that opens up the doorway. Okay. So that opens up the doorway for us to raise our expectations for tomorrow, because we have this wild hope stirring inside of our hearts. And it allows us to get excited about life, even if our circumstances aren't that great, even if things don't look that pretty and we struggle. There's this wild hope that says, oh, God is good, and it's going to be good tomorrow, okay? So good stuff is coming. One of the first devotionals many of you have read, if you're following along, so we've done some of the Declaration book. One of the most powerful benefits of making declarations is that they begin to raise our expectations to see God move in our immediate futures and in the long term. Declarations fuel faith. Let's say that together. Declarations fuel faith. Again, declarations fuel faith.
Can I say that? I gotta say, this is brain stuff.
Right.
If you don't say them out loud, it doesn't do anything for your brain about changing your brain.
Right.
You can read it all you want, but reading doesn't change your brain. Speaking does.
Listen. If we don't believe a solution to a problem exists, our minds won't even look for one. Our minds won't even look for one. However, simply holding the belief that there is always a solution frees your mind to seek one out, and then you release it with your mouth. Likewise, whatever strongholds your mind holds, whether positive or negative, your mind will naturally search for evidence to reinforce what it already believes. You teach that in Triumph Over Trouble. So if you ultimately believe you're rejected, your mind will continually recognize any evidence of rejection and either discard or entirely miss any evidence that you're accepted. As we declare truth, we are demolishing long-standing negative strongholds in our lives and rebuilding foundations of truthful strongholds. Let's declare that. As I declare truth,
I am demolishing
long-standing negative strongholds.
Long-standing negative strongholds
in my life.
And
I am rebuilding foundations. Of truthful strongholds. I will look for solutions. When I face a problem. And I will look for evidence.
That reinforces
who God says I am.
And who God says He is.
Yes. So we do that because I have meditated on. And declared these truths.
Over my life.
I look for solutions.
For any problem I face,
and I look for evidence
that
reinforces who God says I am. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, let's declare this. There is always a solution. I attract solutions. To every problem. Tomorrow is going to be one of the best days of my life. I will wake up. Oh, I have written this wrong, but I'm going to say it. I will wake up with a song. I will wake up with strong faith. I will wake up with strong love. I will wake up with strong hope. In my heart. I will exercise.
Eat right.
Drink a ton of water.
And laugh frequently.
Today and tomorrow. God's kingdom will advance. Everywhere I go.
And in everything I do.
I will be extremely effective.
In everything I put my hand to.
No matter what the work is.
I will have life changing.
Secret place times. With the Lord today and tomorrow. My past prayers will be working mightily.
Will be working mightily
today and tomorrow.
In every situation
that concerns me. So here's one that I like to declare over my life a lot. I say this a lot. Psalm 138:8 in the King James Version says, "He will perfect everything that concerns you."
Yeah.
He will perfect everything that concerns you.
Amen.
Let's say that together. He will perfect.
He will perfect
everything that concerns me.
Everything that concerns me.
So Jeremy, that goes with Philippians 1:6 because teleos, perfection is completion. In Philippians 1:6 says he will complete everything that he started.
Yeah.
And that's a promise.
Right.
It is a promise, so that means it's guaranteed.
Right now.
Right now.
I demolish double-mindedness. And any lack of enthusiasm. So there's about 20, guys. So there's your 20 to get the day started. And we'll do more throughout the day. I find that a lot of mine are having to do with increase. That was one of the things that was prophesied over us down at Bethel a lot. Over and over was about increase. There's increase coming. And everybody that I talked to, when they asked who where I was from, I'm from Roseburg, they would look at me and say, "Roseburg's on fire."
That was
really fun.
Well, I would say that Roseburg was well represented at the state capitol.
Oh, very much so. Yeah, we had a good turnout.
I just was really proud of our little city.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah, so that was an incredible day. There was an awesome thing that happened in the afternoon. So the morning time, we definitely felt that there was some resistance in the spiritual realm. And so we were just worshiping and pushing through. We had a lot of people worshiping with us for help. And so we were just continuing to go and go. And then they got, Franklin got up and gave a very powerful declaration about who we are to be as the church and to lead this country and how to pray powerful prayers to bring breakthrough. And so then we began, they cranked us up like loud. And we began worshiping just our hearts out. And you can just feel the atmosphere just begin to just lift and rise. And so we worshiped from 1 o'clock till 6 o'clock straight through, just and because we didn't think he was gonna get done till 2, but he got done at 1. And so they had to start worshiping then. So we worshiped straight through. So as the crowds kind of cleared out, there were little pockets of people like praying. And there was a lady that was wandering around the tent just before Mom and Dad had to go. And Mom immediately, she said her spirit immediately connected with this gal. And this gal was in a pretty big level of turmoil. I don't know her story or anything that was going on, but you could tell she was in a fight. And she was fighting against darkness. And trying to press in toward the light.
Her name's Eileen.
Eileen, okay. Amen. So she friended Mom on Facebook.
She's 29. She's adorable.
So Mom prayed with her, spent some time with her, and then she kind of wandered around. I saw her a few times. You could tell she just wasn't at peace. She wasn't at peace. So there was another tent, a little canopy, about, I don't know, 20 feet away from us, that there were about 5 women in there just pressing into the heavenlies. I mean, they were just declaring, they were laying hands on people, and this little gal got sucked into that little tent. And they spent the next 2.5 hours basically releasing every demonic force off this gal, and we actually, you could hear the demons going out. So, I mean, they spent intense. So after though, I mean, it got really, really intense, really, really crazy for a little while. We're just worshiping through. And all of a sudden she pops up, she gets in the seat, she's got a big old smile on her face, and everybody's cheering and laughing, and she was completely set free. So we just kind of worshiped through that. We just kept pressing in, worshiping, and there were also other people that got healed through the whole time that we were worshiping. Other people were getting prayed for and healed on the outside of the tent. There was a leg healed, there was a back healed, there was some other healings, and so God just used that time to just really, Jim, the leader of Salem House of Prayer, came up and just began to bawl. He hugged me and began to just weep. And he said, I'm so thankful that you guys were here. In fact, I want to read his text. In fact, that's what everyone who came to us came up and said. It couldn't have been anyone else that was here. Because God just came and breakthrough happened. Let me read this text from Jim. All right, he says, we are just as excited. Oh, no, that's me. I want to thank you guys so much for coming and sewing into Oregon. I can't tell you how much it meant to me. I felt that you guys were instrumental in breaking something open in the spirit today. For real, bro. So happy. So then he says, anyway, so they were just everyone that was so thankful and just affirmed that it was God used it, and so we're thankful. I was blown away. If you haven't seen the pictures from behind, I was absolutely blown away with what I was in the tent, so you couldn't really see. I mean, we were surrounded by people, but the picture from the steps of the state capitol, it's just a sea. Someone showed me the picture. I thought, is that Washington, D.C.? And they're like, no, that's Salem. And so it was just a huge turnout. Awesome. Awesome. So, yeah, they said Salem represented itself better than most of the cities. So a lot of the bigger cities that were represented, it was bigger. So I was thanking the Lord. It looked awesome from that perspective. Anyways,
amen.
So Jeremy, let's pray over Mary.
Okay.
Let's pray over Mary. And so she's just been battling and overcoming, but she needs us to come alongside. So can we just stop and pray over Mary?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Awesome. So I want to pray over the spirit of hopelessness and despair and death. So in the name of Jesus, we call off the spirit of death. We call off the spirit of hopelessness and despair. We call off all lying spirits that have attacked her and told her things that weren't true about her, weren't true about her destiny, weren't true about her worth. So Lord, right now we just call in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
We just call in our Lord and Savior who lives inside this lady. And the Holy Spirit to come, and we cancel all assignments of the enemy, all death threats, and all death plans, and we say you will live and not die, and that you will flourish, and you will grow in beauty, and that your destiny is assured, and that there is a purpose for you in this life, and you are an important part of the body of Christ. Yes. You are the daughter of the Most High King.
Yes.
You are beautiful to Him.
Yes.
You are beautiful to Him.
Yes.
He adores you.
Amen.
He thinks you're beautiful. You are part of His heart. He has set you as a seal upon His heart.
Yeah.
And as a seal upon His arm. He has you tattooed on Him, sis. And all of your tears He has captured in a bottle. And every tiny thing that matters to you matters to Him. And he has a plan for you that is going to come to fruition. And yes. You are not alone. That you have loving friends and loving family who will walk with you through this. And so in Jesus' name, we just trade beauty for ashes. And we just give you a crown of glory and of beauty and of love. Lord, we love this lady. We thank you so much for her life. We thank you that you brought her to us. Thank you, Lord, that you have given us a future and a hope, and that you have not come to destroy us or to harm us or to hurt us. But you've come to give us a future and a hope. I thank you, Lord, that the enemy is a vanquished foe, that he is just a little squirmy, headless snake. And he has no power or authority over the children of the Most High King. And so we just agree with heaven right now. We just send warrior angels to accompany Mary wherever she goes and whatever she does. Thank you, Lord, that we have the authority to commission angels and tell them what to do. So we send loving, ministering angels to walk with her today and tomorrow and the next day. And we just thank you right now that Jesus Christ is with her and never leaves her. Thank you, Lord, that you will never leave her.
It has come at last, salvation and power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ. For the accuser of the brothers and sisters has been thrown down to earth,
yes.
The one who accused them before our God day and night. And they have defeated him by the blood of the Lamb and by their testimony. And they did not love their lives so much that they were afraid to die.
Father God, I just declare rest for Mary's spirit.
Yes.
Her heart is tired. So I just pray right now for a filling of the Holy Spirit that she is so just overwhelmed with your spirit and your peace and your love that she can do nothing but smile over Jesus. That she understands that you are here for her and that everyone around her loves her so much, God. Rest. That she is able to sleep at night. She's able to have peace as she goes throughout the day and joy inside of her heart, Father God. Let it be her joy
again.
Let her just fly in that again.
Yes.
Let her heart just be open to healing into your light, into your love, God.
Yes. So Jesus said this to another Mary.
So because God's children are human beings made of flesh and blood, the Son also became flesh and blood. For only as a human being could he die, and only by dying could he break the power of the devil, who had the power of death. Only in this way could he set free all who have lived their lives as slaves to the fear of dying. He has set us free. He has set us free. He has broken every chain. The curse has been broken according to Galatians 3, and we are free.
And Mary, you're like Esther, and when you come before the king, he extends the scepter. You're always welcome.
Amen.
And your request that you give to the king, he loves to answer your request.
Amen.
So be bold and be brave.
Right.
And ask big and mightily in faith.
And where you're weak, the Holy Spirit wants to be strong.
Just
Jesus, you're my one desire.
I give it all cause you are my only thing.
Jesus, you're my one desire.
You are the apple of my eye.
Jesus, you're my one desire.
The love my heart beats for.
Jesus, you're my one desire.
Jesus, you're my one desire. He's good. Jesus.